this girl. Stand up if you are able. Let's sing together.
All things we may think and act according to your good will, and may live Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. Welcome to Bayview Lutheran Church as we celebrate Christmas 1. I have two announcements that I want to highlight for you today. The first is that I want you to be thinking about the gifts, the talents, and the passions that you have. And take a look at the ministry positions, the boards that are available here at the church, and seeing where your gifts and passions can be tied in to those boards. The second announcement that I have has to do with Bible study. And beginning in 3 weeks, we are going to be starting to do Bible studies here once again at the church. It's going to be starting on the week of January 16th. We are going to have two Bible studies each week. Tuesday morning at 9 a.m., we are going to be having a Bible study that's going to be focused on the gospel reading for the next Sunday. And then at Thursday at 3, we are going to be having a Bible study that is focused in on the second reading that's going to happen the following Sunday. Let us enter into a time of confession and assurance. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who sends the Word with angels, who is made flesh among all people, and who brings peace on all earth. Amen. In Christ, we are bold to name our sin and to cry out for peace. At this time, I ask you to remain in a moment of silence for reflection and lifting those sins up to God. Will you join with me in confession? Holy God, we confess our sins before you. We replace compassion with competition. We seek what is mighty while ignoring the meek. We are quick to anger, but slow to forgive. We have not put on love and bargaining with you. Wrap us in the grace of your powerful word. Swaddle our hearts with your peace, that all we do in word or deed may reflect your love poured among us. Amen. I bring you good news of great joy for all people. God has come among us in the child born of Mary, Christ the Lord. In Christ, your sins are forgiven and you are clothed in peace.
Open our then they would return to their home. Now the boy Samuel continued to grow both in stature and in favor with the Lord and with the people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 148 will be our responsive psalm today. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise God in the heights.
Praise the Lord, all the angels. Sing praise, all the hosts of heaven.
Praise the Lord, sun and moon. Sing praise, all you shining stars.
Praise the Lord, heaven and heavens, and any waters above the heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, who commanded, and they were created. Down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. His mother treasured all these things in her heart. And Jesus increased in wisdom and in years and in divine and human favor. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. At this time, I'll invite the children up front for the children's message. Can you believe it? The parents of Jesus lost Jesus. They lost him. Have your parents ever lost you? We got one no, we got one yes. Okay. I would love to hear the story, but we'll do it when parents aren't around, okay? So here we go. I know that there have been times that we've been in a big crowd. Here we go. Uh-oh. Where's Isaiah? Where's Morgan? Where's Bethany? And we think that maybe we had lost them. But this was quite a story. So they're in town. A lot of you have big families, so it's kind of a crowd. Probably had it at Christmas time, right? Yeah. And so they're all together and they're traveling, and mom and dad think that Jesus is with, you know, friend, cousin, aunt. And then they realize, man, nobody has Jesus. And so they go and say, we have to go find Jesus. And so they travel and they're looking and they're finding Jesus, or trying to. 3 days. Can you imagine what your mom or dad might be like if you were lost for 3 days? And they finally found you. I mean, their anxiety, their blood pressure would probably be up here, you know. And what are you doing? Where were you? Why weren't you with us? And Jesus kind of calmly says, didn't you think that this is where I would be? So my thoughts for you today is that when Joseph and Mary finally found Jesus, Jesus walked with them, and Jesus was obedient. And he listened, and he grew in stature. And so today, I want to challenge you to make sure that you grow in stature, grow in wisdom, and learn more and more about God. And kind of like what we read in the second reading, try to have a sense of peace and be with peace with each and every one. Let us pray. God, thank you so much for this day. Thank you for this time where we are able to celebrate and worship you. And God, just ask us that we will be able to continue to grow in our Christian faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'll ask you to stand up if you can help me with the peace. And so it'll be up on the screen once again. On the count of three, we'll say, the peace of the Lord be with you always, and then they'll respond to us. So on the count of three, 1, 2, 3. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
And may you share that peace safely with one another while the children go out to the children's message. So yesterday was Christmas. For many of us, there were presents under a tree. One of the most common gifts that find their way under Christmas trees are clothes. This week, I came across a useless fact, and I decided that I would share it with you. The global textile industry is worth an estimated 3 and four out mantra. For a while, in our house, we had the following rule. You bring a piece of clothing in, four pieces of clothing had to go out. Goodwill and Amerithrift received a lot of clothing with our rule. However, I bought in to the clothing mentality with Christmas with Isaiah. Isaiah is buying into this Wisconsin sports culture since he has moved up here. So he received a Badgers t-shirt, a Packers flannel shirt, and then a Brewers and Bucks sweatshirt. If you go to a concert, a game, or even a theater production, you have the opportunity to buy clothing. In purchasing, you are celebrating or commemorating an event that you experienced. You are making a claim about what is important to you. The writer of Colossians ties in to this concept. We see a list of traits that are part of being a follower of Christ. Did you catch those traits in our second reading? Listening, compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. I would love to live in a world where these five traits are the core of every individual that I meet. These are not just traits, though. It is deeper. We are not to only wear these like clothing, but we are to embody them. Embody them as part of our own very being. These attributes, though, do not occur with a flip of the switch. They take time. So we are to practice compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Because of God's love for us, we are to embody these. We embody them because we are responding to the amazing grace shown to us in Jesus Christ. Now, I want you to remember something very important. This letter was not written to one individual. It was written to a church community. The group was trying their best to be Christ's new community. One thing that they had learned early on was that the best way to practice these traits was becoming one. If I asked you, what do you believe Bayview is known for? What would you say? I ask you this because the spiritual practices are not just individual venture, but they are a communal one. Then I think that if we had the courage, it would be interesting to knock on the doors around the church and ask them the same question. What would they truly say about us if they were honest? Congregations have a culture that become known. Are they warm? Are they welcoming? Are they giving? We do have the capability of changing the culture if we believe that it needs to be changed. So let's probe it a little bit further. How are we known to others? some of these qualities a little bit more. But the Colossian passage closes by lifting up love as the binder that draws everything together. With this love, we will be bound together. Not in a superficial way, but in a perfect and a whole way. Edwin Friedman was born in New York, was an ordained rabbi, and he worked in the D.C. area for around 35 years. He may be known more for his work in family therapy and leadership consultant roles. I am not a huge fan of his work, but he has some great insight. I bring him up today because his work ties into the concept of community culture. This morning I'm going to share some truth with you that many of you know, but sometimes we need to be reminded of. A toxic individual will spin and spread that toxicity to others. An individual can completely ruin what has happened. Maybe you have seen this occur on a sports team, a workplace environment, or maybe even in a church that you have attended. But the opposite is true, and that is what I want to focus in on today. Margaret Mead says, "Never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world." We know that is true, right? Today, we are reading a letter from 2,000 years ago. We are in this space today because we just celebrated the birth of a baby yesterday. That baby grew up and then gathered a small group of individuals to walk with him while he was on the earth. These men and these women, they witnessed all that he did. Then after the death and resurrection of Jesus, this small group of witnesses continued to tell the story and show others this new way of living. At the Christmas Eve service, part of the liturgy was that we are part of this great story. With our baptism, we have been invited to clothe ourselves with these new garments. For Lutherans, this ties into our affirmation of baptism by our promise to live among God's faithful. Remember, this is about us as a community, not just as individuals. With the stage set, let's circle back to the attributes. And I do want you to think of them in a twofold manner. One, I want you to examine how you can put them in to your daily lives. Then, I want you and us to dream on how we can make sure that these attributes are part of the Bayview DNA. I want to lean in to the definitions that Edward Hiller uses. So here we go. Compassion is a deep empathy with each other. Kindness is a basic, even fundamental, Christian attribute, and it's a clear fruit of the Spirit. Humility. It's the quality of listening, respecting, engaging and honoring one another. Meekness. Meekness is dialing down a personality in cases where others need space to express themselves. Meekness also seeks not to trample on others, but to help them up and along. And patience. Patience is all about what Advent was. Waiting and waiting. But with this, it's waiting and waiting for others. And all five of these, they are held together by love. If we can truly have love as our glue and live these attributes, and if these attributes are what Bayview becomes, we will make a huge difference in Sturgeon Bay, Door County, and around the world. Friends, the road is going to be hard at times. As a church, there are going to be times when we disagree with one another. There are going to be times when forgiveness will be necessary. The writer of Colossians knows this. And this is why they included verse 13, which says, "Bear with one another. And if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you. So you also must forgive." Let me close with a short story. On Thursday afternoon, Cheryl and I was in the sanctuary going through the PowerPoint for the Christmas Eve service. The opening prayer on Christmas Eve included the Lord's Prayer. As we clicked through the presentation, she realized that we also had the Lord's Prayer in its traditional spot at communion. I shared with her that there was no need to make the edit, that we could have the Lord's Prayer twice in the service. The Lord's Prayer and Colossians 3, they have parallel. Forgive our sins as we forgive everyone who has done wrong to us. The Lord's Prayer is a daily confessional prayer for the disciples. It regularly acknowledged the need for a refilling of the Holy Spirit in order to honor Christ and others in everyday life. So let me close with these words. Disciples are not forced to love, but do so in honor of Christ and the body of Christ. May we love, may we forgive, and may we be a congregation that is known for compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Amen. Our hymn of the day, "Joy to the World," and I will ask you to arise for the hymn of the day in our I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated. say thank you so much for the gifts that you have given and blessed this church community with. Thank you for your gifts of time, your talent, and your treasures. Let us lift us up in prayer. Gracious God, your word made flesh brings harmony to the earth. As we offer ourselves in these your gifts, prepare us to receive the grace and the truth that you offer at this table, and renew us in the song of your salvation, in Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He blessed it and he gave thanks. He then broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in the remembrance of me." And then again, after supper, he took the cup. He blessed it and he gave thanks. And he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is my new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, Jesus' name we